Hi, my name is Nick Stasoulis and I'm a hydrologic technician with the main office of the New England Water Science Center. In this video, we will outline the process of setting up an open water measurement in the TRDI Section-by-Section Pro software. Once you're connected to your Adcp and ready to start the measurement, you can either select the New Measurement icon here or select File, New Measurement. A one-page measurement wizard will appear, allowing you to specify the measurement information, file naming, and ADCP configuration. First, fill out the measurement and station information at the top of the page. Notice some of this information will be used for the file name as a default, so while it's not required, it will help populate other information in this dialog. Next, look over the file naming prefix and ensure it's consistent with your office's file naming structure. You can also select the folder to save the measurement files here. Once you are satisfied with the file name and folder information, we can move on to configuring the ADCP. The first step in configuring the ADCP is to make sure you are connected to the ADCP and the correct ADCP information is displayed. The options shown in the setup area will vary based on the unit you are connected to, so it's important the software recognizes the ADCP you're connected to so it can display the proper dialogs. The default duration of 40 seconds is appropriate and is typically not changed. The ADCP transducer depth can be entered here. This value will be used for all stations, though you can adjust this value for individual stations before collecting data. The discharge method should always be set to midsection, the computation method used by the USGS. For open water measurements, select magnitude for the velocity method, which will use the mean velocity magnitude to compute discharge. With this method, the user needs to measure and enter any flow angle if the flow is not perpendicular to the cross-section, something we will discuss in detail in another video. For a Rio Grande, fill out the maximum water depth and water speed, as well as the stream bed type. The secondary depth is typically not used, as you have the ability to stop pinging during data collection, allowing you to re-enter this dialog and edit water depth and speed for each station, if needed. The ability to change configurations in the middle of a measurement is a good option for the Rio Grande and the Stream Pro, which both have a fixed configuration once the ADCP is initiated. The bottom mode is typically left to auto, while the water mode must be selected manually. For more information on these modes, and the modes available for other ADCPs we will discuss, review USGS TNM 3A22, Appendix C. To preview the commands based on your selections, you can click the Commands button here. For a Stream Pro, again fill out maximum water speed and depth, as well as select the water mode. Water mode 13 is limited to about 3 feet of depth and less than 1 foot per second. Otherwise, you will use water mode 12. Ensure the Use Compass checkbox is selected if the Stream Pro you are using has a compass available. Also, ensure Long Range is selected if available, and use the default number of cells and the default cell size. The River Ray, River Pro, and Rio Pro settings are similar to a Rio Grande, except that no bottom mode or water mode selections are needed, as both are left to auto. The depth and water speed information should be populated with a reasonable estimate, and the stream bed information should also be filled out. After filling out the ADCP setup information, ensure you've addressed any warnings here and click OK. Pre-measurement tests are covered in a separate video.